welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Accept others the way they are. This is a pretty cool card. You cannot change other people. To try to change them to fit what you want them to be is like trying to change a dog into a cat into a horse. They are what they are, and you are what you are. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials finished down 190. NASDAQ was off 44. S&P's down 15.5. Bottom line is that you had the Dow Industrials down 0.7%. S&P's off 0.6%. And NASDAQ off 0.5. Kind of a sideways move. That being said, though, if we go over and we take a look at how subtle this is, what you're going to see is that you got an expansion of the volume as you start this little turn. SPY had 62 million. When I started the program, the 3 o'clock hour at 3:06, we were at 40 million. So they dumped 20 million kind of into the close here. You get a slight expansion of volume. That's saying that the SPY now is going to try to get into 285. And that's where we had gapped up. On the 29th of March, we closed at 282. On the 1st of April, we gapped up to 286. So it's going to try to finish that gap, close up that gap. The real question is going to be, as it moves down, do you continue to get a expansion of volume? And what it's going to do when it actually gets into that level? And we're going to find out pretty quick. Small caps, the way the small caps have traded out here today, I suspect we're going to get follow through. And this is why. What has happened in the small caps, folks, is this. The small caps topped out on the 25th of February. They were the first ones that actually went down with some velocity. Now, it certainly wasn't the 25th of February. That's where you had small movements, kind of like in the S&P today. We only moved from 159.50 to 158. They went sideways for another 4 days, and then you got the move. The move that I'm talking about was on March 6th. We went from 156 down to 152. And what was so intriguing about that is that when that came down, what you didn't do is that you didn't get the move in the S&P. The S&P at that particular point only went down, you know, like 3 points. So the move on the small caps was much larger. That being said, guess what? Then you do a little counter trend bounce, and then your next move, also on the 22nd of March, that was a monster. That was absolutely a monster, the one on the 22nd of March. And the 22nd, that's when the IWM went from 154 to 149. Big volume, and I suspect what we're going to see here is that more than likely, that's how this thing probably is going to shake out tomorrow. So we'll see if the S&P follows this baby down. The last time that it was following it down, but it was tepid on the way down. There wasn't a big move. The NDX 100, bottom line, that tried to get to higher price today, didn't have volume on the move, gave it up. The GDX is going to need more volume. What we did out here today is that you're up 13 cents. You've done 23 million shares. We did 30 yesterday. You know, it's going after these highs. And what's going to happen, I suspect, is that we're going to be at the bottom of the high more than likely tomorrow. The bottom of that high is only another 25 cents, $23.14. So if you're in that market, you're going to want an expansion of volume. Notes and bonds had higher price out here today. They also are going to need an expansion of volume. The 10-year note did 1.1 million contracts out here, almost 1.2. Got its head up going a little. Still going to need more volume. The 30-year bond, what we have with the 30-year out here, 30-year was up 11 ticks. And also it's going to need more volume. We did 212,000. And what you'd like to see out here is somewhere into the 300,000s. Now, what they both did do is that they came back to the strength from March 22nd. That's where both the 10-year, the 30-year, the 5-year, you name it, all those bonds broke topside in a whole nother range. We pulled back down into that breakout area. We did it with dramatically lighter volume. Now the question is going to be, can it get any topside volume going as well as price? Some of the higher volume equities out here in this market. In fact, let's take a look at and see volume-wise what we did inside the indices. So inside the NYSE, 757. That's light volume. We did 780 yesterday. Composite, 2 billion. We did 2 billion yesterday. That's not telling us too much. The advanced micro is down $1.27 out here. GE was the highest volume stock. That was down 27 cents. You had U.S. Steel down 197. Let's go over to the steel market. This is going to be interesting looking at the steel market. Okay, so what hit U.S. Steel? This company just is a personality stock beyond belief. Look at this. This is a disaster. Okay, so what's happening here? Let's see. Well, here, let me analyze this first. This thing's going to be a mess. So we put this on a weekly. Oh, man, this could be a monster ABC down. Whoa, baby, watch out. Let's see. Yep, it sure can. You're talking about big numbers here. 30, okay, so the most conservative way is about $30. Wow, it's still huge, $13. Yeah, you're talking about $11. This thing wants to go to $11. And $11 is going to get you over to the break topside of March of 2016. Let me just see AKS. I want to see if the rest of these steel stocks are doing that. Yeah, AKS come down a bit. We'll take a look at Nucor. Steel Dynamics, yeah, Nucor Steel Dynamics, NU. Okay, NUE. So, yeah, the pullback, nothing like U.S. Steel, though. U.S. Steel's in a mess. That stock's been a mess for so long, it's amazing. It's got saved a million times because of tariffs and every other thing, but bottom line, still a mess. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.